What up, everybody? This is my Tulsa King, episode 7, War Acres Breakdown, and the headline is that Chickie kills his dad Pete to become the Mafia Godfather. So RIP to Pete, who was my favorite character on Tulsa King. He is the triple, the quadruple OG. I mean, as gangster as it gets. I mean, he had a couple episodes ago, he had Chickie help him up off his chair just to smack the taste out of it. Help me up. Smack the taste out of his mouth. Oh man, you gotta love Pete, man. So laid back, so chill, so gangster. RIP Pete, you will be missed on this show, but everybody had to see this coming. I don't think too many people expected Pete to survive season 1 of Tulsa King. We knew the time was coming where Chickie was going to take over as the Godfather and things were going to get real interesting. So let's go ahead and get into the story. Pete was told good news at the beginning of the episode. Pete was told good news that he could live up to, after being in the hospital and everything, that he could live up to 15 more years without a problem. And Chickie heard that. I mean, he smiled, but he was not happy about the information. He felt like his dad, ever since his mom died, had become like a giant boulder on his back. So he goes to visit a priest or whatever, and he tells the story about his father. He made him join the mob or mafia, but Chickie actually wanted to join the army and be a colonel or something. So he goes on to tell the priest about the story about how he was just a young kid and his father made him to steal an apple from the store. And I guess it sounds like he got caught and his mom found out. And Chickie told his mom that his dad made him do it. So, and he says that his dad hated him ever since that. I guess possibly that his dad was testing him and he felt that Chickie was a snitch by telling his mom on what he did. So I'm not sure. You can tell me what you think about that particular story about the apple, but I feel like it was Pete testing his young son to see how he would respond, because I feel like he knew. I mean, the whole point of the story is that Pete knew Chickie was going to get caught stealing the apple, so it was going to be about how Chickie actually responded to it. So I think that why he calls, he says that Chickie isn't half the man that Dwight is. So they get to talking about that as Chickie is bathing his dad Pete in the bathtub, and he kills his dad in the bathtub. And in the process, we see Chickie's wig get ruined because Pete reaches up to try to grab Chickie by the hair or whatever, and his wig gets ruined. He tries putting it back on his head, but it didn't fit right. So when he comes downstairs to meet all the guests and everything, he has to come down without the wig on. So he comes down with his bald head. So I'm trying to figure out what the guests are going to think and who will actually figure it out that Chickie murdered his own father, Pete, to become the Godfather. And we definitely see Vince when Pete, I think it's going to be Vince. That's who I think it's going to be, because when we see when Pete is coming down the steps and Vince looks up at Chicky, I don't think I might have just said when Pete was coming down the steps. When Chicky was coming down the steps and Vince looks up at Chicky, he does a double take, and he definitely, when he comes to look to talk to him and ask if there's anything he could do, he definitely has a, I would say, a puzzled look on his face, like, what's going on? Like, really, like, he's trying to figure out why. Like, I mean, he's not going to ask him, obviously, what happened to your, I mean, obviously people knew he was wearing a wig, because when Goody comes to later on, I'm just going to say this, I don't want to get ahead of myself, but Dwight called him a wig wearing something else when first approached by Goody, when Goody arrived from New York to Tulsa. So I think what's going to happen is Vince is going to figure this out, and I think he is going to turn, because right now he's very loyal to Chicky, and he wants Dwight taken out just as much as Chicky. But I think once he figures this out, he is going to turn, I mean, I guess, what would you call it? Turn good guy. I mean, there ain't no really good guys in this show, but turn to the villain, or the whatever you want to call it. His character's going to turn, and he's going to be someone who actually becomes friends with Dwight. That's just my prediction, and they're going to plan to take Chicky out eventually. I don't think which will happen in this season, but then a future time. So we get on to the next storyline, and that is sticking with Chicky. Dwight talking to Tina about her husband getting jumped, and Dwight tells Tina that they need to move to Oklahoma about this. And this is where I was getting to. So Dwight confronts Goody when he arrives to Tulsa, and they say, and he's, so basically Dwight knew this was Chicky, but since nobody else from the mafia knew Chicky was involved in the mugging of Tina's husband, or the beat up, whatever you call it, I guess he didn't get mugged, but when the beat up of Tina's husband, the jumping of Tina's husband, that nobody else from the mafia knew about this, so Goody was completely nonchalant about it, act like, oh, they didn't know nothing about it. Matter of fact, he tells Dwight how Pete stood up for Dwight to Chicky. So as far as they know, they didn't have anything to do about it. But what happens is Tina gets another call from Chicky in the middle of the night, with him just sitting on the phone, breathing, not saying anything. And so this makes her want to move to Oklahoma with her husband, but her husband refuses to do so. So let's stick with Goody here. So as Goody arrives to Tulsa, he is greeted by Tyson and none other than his old-time mafia acquaintance Armin. And he definitely noticed Armin. He asked him, what are you doing here? And it seems like Armin is telling the truth. It definitely didn't snitch. We definitely find out that he definitely ran from New York 18 years ago or whatever. So it seems like it's all good with Armin. Dwight also vouches for Armin with Goody when Goody also asked Dwight what Armin's doing there. And Dwight vouches for him. He says it's all good. And we do know that Armin saved himself by letting him know that Pete in the mafia was behind the hit that was put out for him in prison. But Dwight acts like he doesn't know this with Goody. But it's also reported back to Dwight. Goody also notices that Tyson, Dwight's driver, is wearing the ring that Pete gave to Dwight. So this was also reported back to New York. So this could be also found out also that Dwight might end up knowing about it. But considering that Pete is now dead, I think it's going to be, I think that whole storyline of the ring being given to Tyson is going to be washed away with Pete's death. So moving on, we have the very beginning of the episode. We have Dwight and Mitch burying the body of Carson Pike, who they shot in self-defense from the last episode. But of course, since they're both felons, they went ahead to bury the body instead of reporting it as a self-defense to the cops and have to go through all that trouble. But they send his jacket back to Kalon Waltrip as a message, and it has bullet holes in the jacket. So when the box arrives back to Waltrip and his crew's bar or whatever they hang out at, Roxy is actually the one who brings the box, and Roxy is Carson Pike's girlfriend, who actually is an informant for Stacy Bill in the ATF. So she is there when they opened the box and found out that Carson Pike had been killed, and she breaks down. Waltrip has them get her out of there immediately. She runs directly to Stacy Bill, but Stacy Bill wants info. She tells her to get the info off of Waltrip's laptop, take pictures, do whatever she can do, and this will be the last time that she ever has to go back to Waltrip. After that, Stacy Bill goes to confront Dwight, and we find out she is completely wasted. And we all know from the first episode or two that Stacy Bill is a recovering alcoholic, so she hasn't really been doing too good with her alcoholism in this episode. Seems like it's, matter of fact, getting really bad, because now Roxy goes back to look for the laptop, and she gets her informant Roxy killed at the hands of Kalon Waltrip, because she is caught looking at Waltrip's laptop. So this is showing very poor judgment by Stacy Bill, the ATF agent, sending Roxy back to Waltrip to get anything, to get some kind of evidence, knowing that the girl's boyfriend had just got caught and things were a little hot over there in Waltrip's turf, in the Black McAdams turf, that put this and send her to get and actually get a laptop was definitely poor judgment. She must have been really drunk, and she ended up getting her informant killed. She waits at the diner that they meet up at. Finally, after so long of Roxy not returning back, she calls Roxy's phone, and none other than Kalon Waltrip answers. Now, I want to stick to this. Now, I want to keep this laptop in mind, moving on to Bodie returning back to his shop. We find out that Bodie is actually stealing cryptocurrency, and that he has millions of dollars in cryptocurrency. And now, cryptocurrency, stealing that, this would be what you consider a white collar crime. And this is something that people get big time. Do you think heroin and dope charges get you a lot of time? White collar crime, unknowingly to the people who get involved in it, is giving you those same type of charges. So white collar crime ain't nothing to be take lightly, and think that you're going to do some white collar crime and do some light time just because it's non-violent and not involved in with any drugs or organized crime like that. But that is Not true. You get involved in white collar crime, you can get you find yourself looking to 10 to 20 easily. So we find out that Bodie is involved in stealing cryptocurrency, and he has millions stashed up, and he lets Dwight in on this information because they're gonna use some of this money he has from stealing cryptocurrency to renovate Mitch's bar, and they're gonna turn it into a casino. So now I want to keep that laptop in the stealing of cryptocurrency in mind as I turn it back to Waltrip, because last episode we saw Waltrip looking at a laptop and he was looking at bank account numbers very similar to what Bodie had been looking at, and he also had millions of dollars, almost similar money to what Bodie had in his account. So I'm trying to figure out, is Waltrip also involved in stealing cryptocurrency? Or could Waltrip possibly have his, could he be monitoring Bodie's money? Could he be stealing Bodie's money that actually Bodie is stealing? So this is definitely a storyline to keep involved, keep in mind, that what was actually on, what is those millions of dollars about, that is on Waltrip's laptop. And there you have it, that's the breakdown. Other than that, Dwight goes on a date with the horse farm owner, whatever you want to call it, Margaret. So there you have it. That is my Tulsa King episode 7 War Acres breakdown, and RIP to my favorite character of this series, Pete the Godfather, OG, triple OG, quadruple OG. You will be missed.